चलानां च कर्तारौ वन्दे वाणी विनायकौ भवानी शंकरौ वन्दे श्रद्धा विश्वासरूपिणौ याभ्यां विना न पश्यन्ति सिद्धा स्वान्तस्थमीश्वरं वन्दे बोधमयं नित्यं गुरुं शंकररूपिणं यमाश्रितो हि वक्रोपी चंद्र सर्वत्र वंद्यते सीताराम गुणग्राम पुण्यारण्य विहारिणौ वंदे विशुद्ध विज्ञानौ कवीश्वर कपीश्वरौ उद्भव स्थिति संहार क्लेशहारिणी सर्वश्रेयस्करीं सीतां नतोऽहं रामवल्लभां यन्मायावशवर्तिविश्वमखिलं ब्रह्मादिदेवासुरा यत्सत्त्वादमृषैव भाति सकलं रज्जौ यथा हेर्भ्रमः यत्पादप्लवमेकमेव हि भवां बोधे स्थितीर्षावतां वन्देऽहं तमशेषकारणपरं रामाख्यमीशं हरिं नानापुराणनिगमागमसम्मतं यद् रामायणे निगदितं क्वचिदन्यथोऽपि स्वान्तःसुखाय तुलसीरघुनाथगाथा भाषानिबन्धमतिमञ्जुलमातनोति भाषानिबन्धमतिमञ्जुलमा हरि ओम्। We'll do that Sumiran also. जो सुमिरत सिधि होई गणनायक करीवर बदन करउ अनुग्रह सोई बुद्धि राशि शुभ गुण सदन मूक होई वाचाल पंगु चरई गिरिवर गहन जासु कृपा सोदयाल द्रवौ सकल कलिमल दहन नील सरोरुह श्याम करुण अरिज नयन करौ सोमम उर धाम सदा क्षीर सागर शयन कुंद इंदुद उमारमन करुणा अयन जाहि दीन परनेह करौ कृपा मर्दन मयन वंद गुरु पद कंज कृपा सिंधु नर रूप हरि महामोहतम पुंज यासु वचन रवि कर निकर यासु वचन रवि कर निकर सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। Okay, so now we have to start from where? After number five, yeah? After number five, you see? So that will end at Doha number six. खल अघ अगुण साधु गुण गाथा गाहा उभय अपार उदधि अवगाहा ते ते कछु गुण दोष बखाने संग्रह त्याग न बिनु पहचाने भले उपोच सब विधि उपजाए गनि गुण दोष भेद बिलगाए कहि भेद इतिहास पुराण विधि प्रपंच गुण अवगुण साना दुख सुख पाप पुण्य दिन राति साधु असाधु सुजाति कुजाति दानव देव ऊच अरुणीच अमीय सुजीवन बाहुरुमीच माया ब्रह्म जीव जगदीसा लच्छि अलच्छि रंक अवनीसा काशी मग सुर सरिक्रमनासा मरु मारव महि देव गवासा सरग नरक अनुराग विरागा निगमागम गुण दोष विभागा जड़ चेतन गुण दोषमय विश्व कीन करतार संत हंस गुण गहि पय परिहरि बारि विकार बारि विकार सियावर रामचंद्र की जय पवन सुत हनुमान की जय उमापति की जय बोलो भाई सब संतन की जय खल अग अगुण साधु गुण गाहा उभय अपार उदधि अवगाहा and we left it last night we were singing Tulsidashi telling about all the wicked people but not in a bad way if you want peace of mind you should start doing like Tulsidashi yeah? ठीक है there are wicked people in the world there are negative things in the world but we should not see it in a bad way that is the idea the one who sees all those evil people and negative things in the world in a bad way that person will be tormented forever we have to learn to see that thing is also necessary and yesterday I gave some examples of that also. You may think it is undesirable and unnecessary, but it is very much necessary. Unless you leave this world and go to some other loka. But any loka, if you see the description in Puranas, right? Look here. You just think a little bit. Western people went into India where the Vedas had been existing for thousands and thousands of years, and they took certain little aspects and they made up Western religions and all that kind of thing, you know? And many of it, much of it is quite misinterpreted and all. I tell you, if you see the description of Swarga, people say, oh, I'll go to Swarga and enjoy, like anything. It'll be so much bliss. And so many people do so many rituals to go to Swarga. But you just do a little study of Swarga also, and you will see in Swarga, there is as much sorrow as there is here. There is no less. Quite often, Indra Dev and Agni and Vayu and Amitra and all of them, they are beaten out by Bakasura, this Asura, Asura, and they're beaten out, thrown out, kicked out, and they become vagabonds roaming everywhere, and they become homeless also. Quite often. Now, where is the joy in that? They go begging to Brahmaji, to Lord Shiva, they go everywhere looking for refuge. Quite often, Indra is given so much of sharp, and he has to do all sorts of things. He's a king. Then nobody has gotten more sharp in Purana than Indra. This fellow always doing some wrong thing and always getting some sharp. And the worst type of sharp. Some of them unutterable also. This Indra. So if you talk about Swarga, you talk about any other loka also. This Bhasmasur, he went there and prayed to Lord Shiva to get some power. Right? This is Shiva Lok. He went to pray to Lord Shiva, but he has some power. He put his hand on Lord Shiva's head like this. Not Lord Shiva's, anybody's head. If he wanted this boon, if I put my hand on anybody's head, they will turn to ashes. They'll burn to ashes. So Lord Shiva says, that has to be, he's Ashutosh. Ashutosh means he's easily pleased. Eka Bilvam Shivarpanam. You give one Bilva Patra. He's so pleased. What do you want? I want to become Bhasmasu. I want to have that power to burn anybody. Anything, he's so easily pleased. Lord Shiva said, that has to. But that fellow, that Asura, he got that power. On anybody's head, he put his hand like this, they will turn to ashes. Then when after he got the power, he was doubting whether he had that power or not. He doubted whether he had the power. Then he told Lord Shiva, since you are here already, let me test it on yourself. Let me test on you only. Now from Shiva Lok he has to run. Now see this thing. Where there is no sorrow, Shiva Lok also. Which loka doesn't have sorrow? So that's what we are telling. The pairs of opposites are there present. You just study the Sri Purana a little bit. Everywhere. That is why the rishis in the Upanishads, they sought moksha, mukti, to go beyond the pairs of opposite. Once you stay in the manifested universe, the thing that holds up the manifested universe as manifest is duality. And we'll be subject to the duality. So Tulsidasji is here, is juxtaposing all the sadhus and all the asadhu. Asadhu means opposite of sadhu. Asadhu doesn't mean like a sadhu. Sadhu and asadhu he calls. Sadhu, asadhu, sadhana, sukha, sari, that verse will come just now. Sadhu, asadhu, the opposite of sadhu. So he's juxtaposing these two like this. And making a very strong point. And this point is so strong, Tulsidasji, last night we spoke so much about it. He doesn't leave it. Today also now this thing is continue. He means to say he wants to impress on our mind this understanding that you live in a world of duality. You know, sometimes in these, in Trinidad, I don't know, those of you who have come from abroad, you will not know, but in Trinidad, we have something called maxi taxi. Maxi taxi. Maxi taxi means what? That's a taxi that takes maximum people. Right? So again, maxi taxi, like that. So anyway, it's a regular taxi in Trinidad, not like America, yeah? You know what is? What is worse than raining cats and dogs? Hailing taxis. Anyway, if you get it, you get it. If you don't get it, you don't get it. Yes, that too in New York, yeah. Anyway, so in Trinidad, we have something called maxi taxi. So it's a bus that, you know what's a maxi taxi? See, we have a bus outside there, small bus, that is called a maxi taxi because it can carry about a dozen people one time. So they have to have a special license and all to do it. We don't have a license here, but to carry that, yeah. It means we don't have a license to ply on the road. We can carry our own private satsangis and all that. We have a license for that. We can't go and take fares from... Don't illegit, eh? Don't worry. So, these maxi taxis, in their front windshield, at the top, you will always see some little quote or some this or some that. Oh, in their back window also. Something will be written there. Most of the time, it's all negative things. So one thing which you will see written there, and now you see it after this US election also, deal with it. Have you seen? Yes. The deal Trump, he said. So anyway, that's a card joke. Anyway. He knows how to stack it up, you know. But anyways, so here, once you are not realized and you live in this manifested world, there is the pairs of opposite, there will be positive and negative, good and bad, joy and sorrow, you know, right and wrong, joy and what do you call that, victory and defeat. Deal with it. That is the idea. For those who can't, Sorrow. And what happens, instead of human beings learning to deal with it, we all the time try to run away from it. That is our problem. But when you run from the fire, when you run from the frying pan, you run into the fire. That is the thing. That will come later on in Kishkindakand also. We're trying to run from it all the time. So Ramayana teaches all, see, whatever things are being laid down here, this will come in story form. So this is philosophical principles are being laid down. The world is, the manifested universe is characterized by the pairs of opposite, and you can't escape it. You may jump high or jump low, you just have to deal with it. That is the idea. So he said, now look here. He continues the same topic. Khala, agha, aguna. Khala means wicked people. Agha means pap, sins. Aguna means all negative traits and qualities. And this is three things he names. Then, sadhu, guna, gaha. Sadhu, guna, gaha means all the great qualities of sadhu, good qualities. So what, three bad qualities he gives, and all the good qualities of sadhus. He says, ubhaya, apar. Both are limitless. Means all good qualities are limitless, and bad qualities are also limitless. Udadi avagaha. Unfathomable, like the ocean. Udadi is ocean. Like the ocean means so much. Good qualities and bad qualities. No end to them. Then, tehite kachu guna dosha bakhane. From amongst them, I just told a few. Just one or two. Why I told? Sangraha tyagana binu pahichane. This is a very good, see, the same thing happens in Bhagavad Gita in the 16th chapter. Bhagavan makes two lists. One he calls it Daivi Sampat, and the other he calls it Asuri Sampat. You know that, na? In 16th chapter, we'll see there. All divine qualities, and all negative qualities like this. How is it opposite of divine? Non-divine? Devilish quality. Demonic qualities, yes.
So he makes two lists there. So then people are, why Bhagavan has to tell these negative things, you know? So Tulsidas gives a wonderful reply here. He says, Sangraha Tyag Na Binu Pehichane. It means if we do not recognize what is good quality and what is bad quality, we will not be able to pick up the good quality and drop the bad quality. Because many times we don't know what is the good quality and bad quality and all. Right now, human beings, they practice such terrible hypocritical qualities and all, and they think it's good. So we human beings also don't know which is great qualities, you know, what is good, what is not good and all. Very difficult thing to know. That's why you need Vedas. Just now that will come also. I'll give you a simple example. Look here. In China, they have a big dog eating festival. They're eating dogs like anything. They're killing dogs like anything. And these American people who treat dogs better than human beings, they're protesting. They're protesting. People left America and flew to China to go and protest. Can you imagine? Why? Chinese people are eating dogs. Oh, such a cute puppy. How can you kill such a cute animal? And that same fellow doesn't think that Indians rever cows and he's eating cow like anything. What reverence we have for cows? He doesn't, but hypocrisy only. But he doesn't know that he has a hypocritical quality. He cannot even see. That's a pehchane. Pehchane you have to recognize. He is a hypocrite and he doesn't know. Only when we know, oh, really? I have never thought of it. My God, I am such a hypocrite. When he recognized, pehchane was a strong word, you know. A very important word there, to see that. We know, pehchane na tyage. We will not be able to drop. Grahana tyag. Sangraha means grahan, to take it up. Unless you recognize, well, look, I've been doing something really stupid, I never knew. So that is why I've given all these negative qualities. And one more important point in that, if Tulsidas is giving all these negative qualities, it's for us to recognize in who? In ourselves, not in somebody else. At one place, I was doing this same 16th chapter, Daivi Sampat, Asuri Sampat. When I gave that list of all Asuri Sampat, one man came after the lecture and told me, Swamiji, I know somebody with all those bad qualities. He knows somebody with all those. Arey bhai, that is not given for you to see who has bad qualities. That is given to see how much you have. And the answer will be all. Just in different degrees. I will have all those bad qualities only in different degrees only. Some I'll have more, some I'll have less. So binu pehchane, without recognizing na sangraha tyaga, I will not be able to take them up or drop them, you know. Bhaleu poche sab vidhi upajaye. And see, this line will explain very important thing connected with that line only. Good and evil. Bhaleu poche. Bhaleu poche will come again and again. This phrase come together all the time. Bhaleu poche means good and evil, good and bad. Bhaleu poch, sab vidhi upajaye, both manifest from Brahma, from the Lord only. Good and evil manifest from the Lord only. And last night we saw sort of example also with Kashyap Muni and Diti and Aditi. So it's a bhaleu poch, sab vidhi upajaye, both came from the Lord only. But ganiya guna dosha beda bilagaye, and this is a very important line and a very nice line. The Vedas has ganiya. Ganiya means counted them, means the Vedas have separated them. Okay, these are good qualities and these are evil qualities. Otherwise, we will not know. That's why Vedas are there. Vedas tell them this is good quality and this is evil quality. So therefore, you take up this one and stay away from this one. Why? It means stay away, don't practice it. You can't avoid it, it will come. You don't promote and promulgate and fortify and strengthen these bad qualities. They'll keep coming, you just keep. Because these good qualities are conducive to sadhana, by which we can get realization and transcend both good and evil. Maybe we're all the time tormented by these evil ones, and we go on practicing evil qualities. Then we'll not be able to find ourselves in a state where we can transcend both. So the good qualities are conducive to sadhana. That is all. But you can't get rid of them. They will be there. Okay. We practice the good qualities. So the Vedas separate them. Gani guna dosh. The Vedas count. Yeah, Gani will literally count. But the Vedas, how you'll say that? Classify. Huh? That is a better thing. Classify. It is the Vedas which classify guna and dosh. Means good qualities and bad qualities. Veda bilagae. Separate them so you will know clearly. Because just now we said pehchane, you have to recognize. So what is our help to recognize what is guna and what is dosha? Guna means good quality, dosha means bad quality. What is our help? The Vedas. That is the answer. Kahahi veda itihasa purana vidhi prapancha guna avaguna sana. Kahahi veda itihasa purana. The Vedas, the itihas and the puranas. They all say kahahi. What they say? Vidhi prapancha guna avaguna sana. And this line I've been telling you, this sana word is very much known to Trinidadians and maybe Guyanese also. This sana word we use all the time because they used to say in Trinidad, I don't know, Baba will tell in Guyana also, when you get dal and bhat and bhaji with your hand, you have to sane that thing. In Hindi, there's a verb sanna. Sanna means to dal, bhaj, bhaji, dal, bhat, bhaji, and you. And longer, and you make a little ball and dal and bhat and bhaji. You know what? Sane comes from Hindi, sanna. Here, sana, see? So this, he says, good and evil are there, and now that you have to think about that sane thing. Eh? After you mix these three, how you will separate them after that? In the very same way, positive and negative, good and evil, they are mixed intimately into every single thing in this universe. So much so that the two things are indistinguishable almost. And they are there in the same thing at one and the same time. The pairs of opposites. That's how that is symbolized by this great and wonderful discovery which scientists made recently in the last 100 years and all. What is that? In the atom there is positive and negative together and you can't remove any. What we mean to say, the pairs of opposites are there together in one and the same thing. So one and the same thing is both. That is how close. Eh? Sana word, or sana, which is given here, indicates that thing. Let me give you an example, then you will know that, what I am telling. Easiest example I give. I am tall and short at the same time. Now tall and short is two opposite, isn't it? But I am tall and short at the same time. And everything in the world is like that. Recently only somebody looked at me in front of my mother and said, really? I was standing in front of my mother, you are tall. But if I stand in front of Kareem Abdul Jabbar, how's the weather up there? I'll ask him. So I will be short like anything, isn't it? So everybody, everything is like that. Huh? Wasn't it tall and short at the same time? Things are hot and cold at the same time. A pot of boiling water, we say it's hot. But really speaking, that is only a perspective. Because right down here, if you stand here, you'll see some lights over there. A lot of lights, there's a steel mill there. Steel mill. And steel is boiling at 2,300 degrees Celsius. So you carry a 100 degrees Celsius pot of water and you ask that steel, what do you think about this guy? Is he hot or cold? That steel will say, what? Hot. He is experiencing winter. So, he is hot only from a certain perspective. From that fellow's perspective, this fellow is cold. So he's hot and cold now or what? Both, na? At the same time. Depending. That's why we say we live in a relative universe. The definition of relative universe means the two things are there in one and the same thing at one and the same time. From this side, huh? 6 and 9. If I write 6 here and I show it to you, then what it will look like? 9. So what is it, 6 or 9? Well, both. It is two at the same time. So here he says, see the line, how important that little line is. It says, vidhi prapanchu guna avaguna sana. The guna and avaguna mixed into one and the same thing at one and the same time. Puja is good or bad? So you haven't thought the other side also, you see. Puja is good. From our perspective, for this class and all, good. But there are so many things if you check. You go on outside and you ask the bilwa tree. And you ask the flower plant. Puja is good or bad? If he even hears the word puja, he'll start to cry. He'll start crying. Because you every morning, early morning, everybody's still sleeping. Bechara, peer. Vriksha, sleeping, you go there. How you like somebody come pull out your ears in the early morning like that one? What are you doing? No. Bhagwan ko chadhane ke liye main ja raha hu. I'm going to offer to Bhagwan. That tree cares anything about you going to offer to Bhagwan? For that tree, it is a nightmare. Science tells not trees also cry. They have done so many research. When you pluck anything from the tree, it cries. So now see, puja is good or bad? It depends on who you're talking about. Na? So, he says, the guna and avaguna are mixed into everything like that. Now, he gives a big list of these pairs of opposites. So, dukkha sukha, you know. Dukkha sukha. Papa punya. Dukkha means sorrow. Sukha means joy. Papa punya. Sin and merit. Dinarati. Day and night. See all the pairs of opposites. Sadhu, asadhu. That's not what I was telling you about just now. As much as there is sadhu, there is also asadhu. Sujati kujati. Good birth and evil birth. Good born in a good home and born in a bad home. There's some children. Oh, bapre. You see on social media and all, what kind of home some children are born. I saw just yesterday or the day before yesterday, that boy is only about 3 or 4 years old and he's smoking like anything. Like a chimney, man. What home he is born in and what environment and who is the people? 4 year old. But so there is sujati and kujati. Then Danava Dev. Danava Deva means Rakshasas and gods. Asuras and gods. Ucha or Nichu. High and low. It means exalted and the opposite of that. Amiya Sujivana Maharu Michu. There is on one side immortality and good life, and on the other side poison and death. It's amrit and good life. And poison and death on the other side. Maya Brahma. Maya and Brahma. See the pairs of opposites? జీవ జగదీస
దోరంగ దునియాకే.
ఇన్ ది వరల్డ్ దే ఆర్ టూ
ఆర్ దోరాస్తే.
ఎవ్రీథింగ్ టూ టూస్ టూస్ ఇన్ ది వరల్డ్. దట్స్ వై ఇన్ సంస్కృత్ వీ హ్యావ్ అ డ్యువల్ కేస్.
Aha, you see, we didn't leave a dual case.
Maya, Brahma, Jeeva, Jagadisa, the Jeeva, the individual being, and Jagadish, the Lord. Lachiya Lachi, Lachi Lachi means affluence and poverty. Lachi is Lakshmi, Lachi is Lakshmi, Lakshmi means paisa. Paisa money? Wealth, money. Paisa one. Dhanavan. Lachi, alachi. Affluence and poverty. Rank avanisa. Rank avanisa. Rank means a beggar. Avanisa means a king. Beggars and kings. Avanisa is Sanskrit, eh? And lachi is Lakshmi. That is also Sanskrit. All the words have their Sanskrit roots, Sanskrit derivations. Kasi mug. Kasi and mug. Kasi means Kasi and mug. How one is the opposite of the other? Because he's giving pairs of opposite. How Kasi? Magad means Magad. Magad means. Oh, last night I was telling you that story, na? Of Trishanku. So it is said that when he was falling, Trishanku, the Karmanash River came. I told you how that thing came. Also, his chariot, he had gone with his chariot. That chariot had cast a shadow. And whichever space that chariot had cast a shadow on the earth, that place became Magad. And it is said that if anybody dies in Magad, he'll surely get a terrible birth. And Kashi is what? If you die in Kashi, you get moksha. So they are opposite because of that. In Kashi, if you die, Kashi marat mukta karat ek ramanam. You heard? Kashi marat mukta karat ek ramanam. Means, Bhagavan Shiva is there in Kashi. He chants the name of Ram in your air, in our air while we are dying in Kashi. And because we hear the name Ram while dying, we get moksha. He only chants in Kashi. If you die here, he will not chant. So you have to go to Kashi to die. You think it's a joke? How many people still go to Kashi to die? Up till now. I have met many people on banks of Ganga there. Baba ji, aap kya kar rahe hai? What are you doing here? Kya kahun beta? What to tell you, my son? Mrityu ke liye intezaar kar raha hun. I am waiting for Yamraj. They tell. So, Kashi Marat. So, Kashi is opposite of Magad. Magad, because if you die in Kashi, you get moksha. If you die in Magad, you get patal. Patal means narak. Because that's how they become opposite. You, I'm so glad nobody asked me where it is. Where is this Magad? I don't know. You go and find out. I also don't know. Right? Some people say it is somewhere in Madhya Pradesh, somewhere. Magad. So Magad. Surasari Kramanasa. Yesterday we saw that. Surasari Ganga Kramanasa is that other river we are telling. That nobody touches, all your fortune will. If you take a dip in that Kramanasa. So they are the pairs of opposite. Marumarav. Marumarav means Marwar and Malwa. Marwar and Malwa opposite of each other? Malwa is also in Madhya Pradesh today, Malwa, which is near Indore, you know that place? Malwa. It is said that in the old days, Malwa used to be a great kingdom with so much of they found so much of what you call that, minerals and gold and all sorts of things in Malwa. And Marwar, which is a desert only, what you'll find there? Nothing. So that's how they are opposite. Marwar, desert. Mahidevan, Gawasa. Gawasa means a cow eater. Cow eater. Butcher also, yes. Actually, literally, it will be cow eater. How? Because of Asa. Gawasa. Asa means Asha. Asha means Asha, not Asha. Asha. Asha means Ashnan. You see that in Gita. Ash means to eat in Sanskrit. So the Alisha Sha become Sa. I told, na? Sha becomes Sa and Va becomes Ba. So Asha. Asha, because at the end of the line, it becomes Asha. Asha. Asa. Like that. So one who eats cow. You know, oh, butcher. So he's opposite to what? Mahidev. Mahidev here means the gods of the earth. The gods of the earth means Brahmanas. So these are opposite. One who eats cow and the Brahmana. Sarag and Narak. Sarag means heaven. Narak means hell. People ask in Hinduism, there is heaven and hell? There is. Not only that, much better than that. Why do you think only heaven and hell? We have many heavens and many hells. Different classes of hells also. You have a choice. When you go, you know. Yeah. So many different types of hells are there. Well, you could choose also. We tick this box. Tick which hell you want there. Kumbhi Paka, Naraka. Like we, all different types of hells are there. Okay, so Narak and Sarag. The difference is, hell and heaven in Hinduism is not eternal, like other religions. Other religions, once you go to hell or heaven, that's it. Finito. In other religions. In Hinduism, we keep moving from loka to loka. Hell is a loka only, heaven is another loka, different lokas. So you keep moving from loka to loka. Anurag and Birag. Haha. Anurag and Birag. Here, now see how they will become opposite. Anurag means strong attachment. And Virag means detachment. So here Anurag is negative Anurag and not the one we were talking about previously. It's not love for God. Here Anurag means severe attachment for worldly things. Lethal attachment. There's Anurag here. Then only it will become opposite, na? Because Virag is the opposite. Virag is total dispassion. Nigama agama guna dosha vibhaga. The nigama and the agama guna and dosha vibhaga. They separate guna and dosha. All the scriptures, in other words. Nigama agama guna dosha vibhaga. All these scriptures, nigama and agama, Vedas and Puranas and all the utterances of the tantra and all, they separate this guna and dosha. Jar chetana guna dosha maya besrakin kartar. Kartar means he has done. Vishwa, Lord, Vidua. He has done what? Jar chetana guna dosha maya. He has made the whole world mixed with jara and chetan guna and dosh. Jada and Chetan means inert and life. Inert things and living things. And all this, at the same time, guna and dosha. Good and evil. So the whole world is now mixed up with this. Jada Chetan. Inertness and life. And mixed with also good and evil. But see the next line, how nice. Santa Hansa Guna Gai Paya Parihari Bari Bikar. But the saint or the saint is like the Hansa bird. Santa Hansa Guna Gai Paya. He takes the guna. Guna Gai means the grahan. Gai means grahan. Grahan means he takes the guna, the good from it, like the milk from the water. Parihari Bari. he drops the handsome bird is said to be able to extract from the water the milk and leave the water. So who is able to do that? Santa. Hans. He's like the Hans. Santa Hans. Bharata Hans. Bharata. Bhagavan is saying, we'll see that in Ayodhya Kand. The Lord himself will praise Bharat. Ravi Vansa Taraga. In this Ravi Vansh, in the dynasty of Raghu, the only Hans is Bharat. Bhagavan Ram himself will tell that. So the Hansa is Sant. It means to say, the only Sant we had in this Raghu dynasty is Bharat. Okay, now we'll see the next one. Let's go. Now see, at the end of the next section, there are four Dohas. Four Dohas. So we'll sing the Siyabara Ramachandra Kiya after the last Doha only. Yeah? See that. Okay. Asabibek Javadei Vidhata. तव तजि दोष गुण हि मनुराता काल स्वभाव करम बरि आई भले उ प्रकृति वसचु भलाई भले उ प्रकृति बस चुकई बलाई सो सुधारी हरि जन जे मिले ही दलि दुख दोष बिमल जसु देई खलौ करहि बल पाई सुसंगु मिटई न मलिन सुभाव अभंगु लखि सुबेश जग बंचक जेउ वेश प्रताप पूजिय हितेउ पुगरहि अंत न होइ निबाहु काल निमिरि मिरावन राहु येहु कुवेश साधु सन मानु जिमि जग जाम वंत हनुमानु हानि कुसंग सुसंगति लाहु लोकहु वेद विदित सब काहू गगन चढ़ई रज पवन प्रसंगा कीच हि मिलई नीच जल संगा साधु असाधु सदन सुख सारी सुमिरहि राम देहि गनि गारी धूम कुसंगति काखिय होई
धूम कुसंगति कारिख होए लिखिय पुराण मंजो मसी सोए सोई जल अनल अनिल संगाता सोई जल अनल अनिल संघाता होई जलद जग जीवन दाता ग्रह वेशज जल पवन पट पाई कुजोग सुजोग होई कुवस्तु सुवस्तु जग लखहि सुलच्छन लोग सम प्रकाश तम पाक दुहु नाम भेद विधि कीन शशि शोषक पोषक समुझे जग जस अपजस दीन जड़ चेतन जग जीव जत सकल राममय जानी बंदौ सबके पद कमल सदा जोरी जोग पानी देव दनुज नर नाग खग प्रेत पितर गंधर्व बंदौ किन्नर रजनी चर कृपा करौ अवसर्व सर्वसियावर रामचंद्र की जय पवन सुत हनुमान की जय उमापति महादेव की जय बोलो जय असविवेक जब दे भी थाता व्हेन भगवान गिव सम विवेक बाय चांस फिर तब तजिदोष गुण ही मनु राता then only that person through that vivek will drop all his worldly attachments and all his avaguna defects and what manurata will become attached to god manurata means mind will revel in god anurakta rata means anurakta Rakta means develop attachment for Bhagwan. Then, Kaal Subhav Karam Bari I, but taken over by the force of Kaal Subhav Karam. Kaal means some time. Taken over by the force of time. Subhav is own nature. Karam, karma. Prarabdha karma and any type of other karma. Bhale u prakriti basa.
which are all parts of Prakriti only. Our Prakriti Netya brings for us time, karma, and Netya. These are all part of Prakriti when we are taken over by our negative Prakriti. Chukai bhalai. He slips. If he has Viveka, he'll get attachment to God. But if he's taken over by some bad karma of the past, and his Prakriti comes down on him, his Netya comes down on him, bad karma and all, then he slips. Then what happens? That fellow, if he's lucky, so sudhari hari jana jimilehi dali dukh dosha bimala jasudehi. He may get the company of some harijan. Harijan means some bhakta, some devotee, some sadhu, some santa. That person gets that company. That sadhu, santa, or whoever it is, may befriend him and destroy his dukkha dosha and bimala jasudehi and give him some good name and fame. And jasu, jasu means some glory. Name, fame. It means to say, if that person also who has fallen in dire straits and all bad things is going on, if some sadhu, some harijan finds him, some guru, some saint, like how Narharidas found Tulsidas, he might be reflecting on his own. See, Prakriti, Kala, Karma, his past karma, Netya, Swabhav, all what things happened to him, you see? And then Narharidas found him and destroyed his all. What is the word given here? Dukkha dosha. Destroy that dukkha dosha. Then what? Jasudehi. Bimala jasudehi. He gave him spotless glory. But then? Khalau karahi valapai susangu mitaina malina subhau abhangu. But if that person is wicked down inside his heart, khalau karahi valapai susangu, and he gets a satsang also, mitai namalena subhau abhangu. It means that that person is truly wicked inside, and you take him to satsang also, nothing will happen. And satsang doesn't have any power or what? Lakhi subesha jagabanchakat jeu besha pratapa pujiyahi teu. It means that. And he gave, no? He'll give examples also, we'll see. That, where we saw, if you take up anything, you take up, let me tell you in Trinidad language, you'll see, Trinidad has such nice things, you know. He said, if you bathe a pig in milk, he will still be a pig. What is the American equivalent for that? Lipstick on a pig? Really? Yeah. Lipstick on a pig? Good, I learn something every day. No, so then does it speak of the satsang doesn't have the power then? Because every satsang is praise, na? So no, that is not the meaning. The meaning is, you take him to satsang one day, nothing will happen. That person has to find himself in satsang over and over and over for lifetimes. Then something will happen. Hey, look, those things can work miracles. See, we have a dog there that prostrates. In many ashrams I have been, I have seen animals also get the effect of that ashram. I've seen most sensible animals in Ramana ashram. That environment can do something to them. So, environment can do something even to an animal. What to talk about a human being? It will. What is meant there? One time you take him to satsang, and then many people were like that only. They go satsang one time, and nothing happened. What is the use of going there? In fact, when I went there, I saw many negative things. So then that person, that satsang will not do anything.
लखिसुवेश जगबंचक ले जेऊ वेश प्रताप पूजी अहि तेऊ मीन्स इवन अ बंचक बंचक मीन्स अ डायबोलिकल क्रूक बंचक मीन्स अ थीफ अ स्विंडलर एम्बेजलर पिक पॉकेट एनी ऑल दोस थिंग्स टुगेदर यू पुट बंचक बंचक मीन्स अ ठग ठग मीन्स डाकू द नाइस वर्ड वी हैव इन हिंदी एंड ऑल ठग एंड डाकू एंड डकोइट is banchak. He says, lucky suvesh, if you see him in nice clothes, if he puts on nice sadhu clothes, dhoti, kurta, mala, he put both. he'll catch Shaivite and he'll catch Vaishnavites also. Right? He dressed up very nicely, even if banchak he may be. He says, besha pratap pujayi tevu. By the power and force of the vesha, the clothes itself, he becomes worshipable. People will worship that fellow. Tulsi Dasji, how nicely it is. He says, Ugarahi antana hoyini bahu kala nemijimi ravana rahu. He says, sooner or later, he will be exposed. He can't maintain it for too long. Like Rahu, he gives three of them. Kala Nemi, Ravan, and Kala Nemi, Ravan, and Rahu. Well, what is that? Putting on clothes and this and that. If you see the story of these three of them, Ravan went to kidnap Sitaji as a sadhu, correct? He changed himself into a sadhu. But in the end, sadhu Baba gone. Ravan was removed. Tulsi Dasji, when we get there, you'll see. People say sadhu. Tulsi Dasji writes such a strong word. That word, anytime I read that thing, like hits me like. He said, swan kinai. Swan means a dog. Not like only like sadhu. He went there like a... Tulsi Dasji, very harsh with Ravan. When Tulsi Dasji cannot be harsh with certain people because his heart is too soft. But when time to be harsh, he said, Ravan went there like a dog. What a strong word. I have not seen that word anywhere. So, he went there pretending to be sadhu, but he couldn't keep that for too long. Pretty soon he is. Kal Nemi also. He also like a sadhu de ashram. Hanumanji went there. That story is very funny. Kal Nemi story, you know? Kal Nemi was one of Ravan's henchmen. When Hanumanji was going for Sanjeevani Bhuti in mountain, Ravan told Kal Nemi, you go there, he's going for Sanjeevani Bhuti. When you go there, make sure he doesn't come back. Because if he comes back to Sanjeevani Bhuti, Lakshmana will be revived. So make sure, and that time limit was there, before daybreak or something. Some time limit was there, na? So you detain him there or something, you know, delay him there. So he doesn't come back. So Kal Nemi na Rakshasa, Ravan's guy. Hitman. He went there and with his magical powers and all, he made a little hut. Kutir. And he sat there, mala, nama, Hanumanji came. Mountain disease. Are? Vata? Vatu? Where you came from? Nicely he spoke to Hanumanji. Hanumanji realized the whole thing from the beginning itself. So he said, you go there. He said, take a bath and come back here. I'll give you mantra. I'll give you some mantra and all. Hanumanji said, okay, take care. I'll go there, take a bath and all. But you know something? When you give me mantra, I'll have to give you some Guru Dakshina.
When you give mantra, I'll have to give some guru dakshina at the end, you know, because the shishya has to give some dakshina to guru. But this is the first time in history that I will give the dakshina before getting the mantra. Before mantra and all he gave. He finished that. Kalanemi. So he went there also like sadhu. And this Rahu. Rahu is Rakshasa, came and sat in the form of Deva on Deva's side. Now we were seeing that story yesterday. So it says, they quickly become. Yeah, removed. They are quickly removed. Exposed. Ugarahi, what is there? Kehu kubesha sadhu sanumanu jimi hanuman jaga jamavant hanuman. What an example is so nice. But he said, look at this. He said, if that person, he's juxtaposing two things there. If this person, he may be dressed up in the best sadhu clothes, sadhu vesh, and he is like Ravan and what is the Kalanemi and all, and he dressed up in the best sadhu clothes, sooner or later he will be exposed. Second thing there. But suppose he has the worst outer appearance, like Hanuman and Jamavant. Suppose he has the worst outer appearance, like Jamavant and Hanuman. If inside he is sadhu, the world will worship. It doesn't matter the outside, the outer appearance, you see. Kiehu kubesh. He dressed up in the worst way. He looks like a bear or monkey. Kubesh. Sadhu sanumanu jimi jaga jamavanta hanumanu. Example again. Okay. Now, just put a mark where we reach. We will finish that tomorrow. He is still talking about the pairs of opposites in the world. All right.